Well, now that we have this built, there's a couple different options that you can do. Since the internal diffusion panel is about 3 foot across, the outer diameter is 5. Finding a piece of gel that would be that big to change the color of the light may be a little bit difficult to do. So you can change the quality of the light coming out of this with these inserts that come along with this light. There is a silver insert and a gold insert. So what you can do with these is they attach inside the softbox. Whether you wanted to just go with 2 panels to get a little bit of a gold reflection to it, or if you wanted to go with a full 4 panels to get a full gold reflection out of it. And there's even one that goes inside of the backsplash as well, so that you can turn this into a full warm tone if you need it in an instance. But in this case, I'm just showing you how you can put one in here. You would use the gold if you want to warm up the skin tone of a person, or if you were shooting in a sunset hour and you wanted your flash to match more of the natural light that's going on at the time. You use the silver side, it's going to add a specularity to the light, which means that if you have something that's metal, it's going to add a little bit of a shine to the reflections that are coming out of it. When you're buying a softbox, you want to make sure that you look for one that does have a double diffusion panel inside of it. Some of the more inexpensive softboxes might not have both of those panels in. It is very important, I think, to the quality of the light and getting an even tone across the front of it that you do have one that has both the baffle inside and the front diffusion. So this attaches with these little Velcro hooks. So now with the baffle in place, we actually have our front diffusion now. It's much like the baffle inside of it, but it's just a little bit bigger, and this actually connects to the outside. Now, this is a feature that I do like on these softboxes, is this little lip on the outside of. Now I'm going to attach the screen here to show you. It doesn't actually go out all the way to the edge. There's a little bit of a black that's still showing, and there's a couple reasons that you would want to leave that lip. One is you might want to use a grid attachment that would connect to this piece of Velcro, or this can also be used as almost like a barn door to control the spread of the light, so that way your diffusion panel, the actual source of your light, isn't out at the edge of your light. There's actually a little bit of a recess to it that actually controls some of the directionality of it. Some of the better softboxes that you see on the market that probably cost a little bit more have bigger lips or more of an angled lip or something like that. This is definitely a nice feature to look for when you're buying a softbox. Alright, so now we have our softbox built. We got our diffusion panel on the front. Now if we fired this up and lit it up, it would probably flare right into the lens and that wouldn't work out for us. But this gives you a really nice soft light. Now if you had your model this close to the light, you would have incredibly soft light because you had to have light from behind all the way over here in front of them, and they would have this real nice soft cast of beautifully soft lighting. Of course, you'd have to crop it creatively so that way this isn't actually in the frame. But it gives you an idea of just the size of this. I'm a 6 foot tall guy, and it's coming to about mid-thigh over my head here. So we're going to actually show you some samples of what this nice big soft light can do, and then we'll show you a setup with this actually in place.
Well, here we have our assembled light, and as Ed mentioned earlier, there's a bit of an edge to the softbox which allows the light to have some direction. If you really need to control the direction of your light, though, there's another piece of a modifier called a grid, and I've got the one for the OctoDome here in my hand. Basically, it looks like a giant honeycomb sort of material, and you can see as I turn it that you can only see through it from directly on. And so when we attach that to our softbox front, it controls all the light to come directly out of the light. So we're going to attach that to our OctoDome because we're going to want real good control of our light for this next shot. So the grid has been attached to the outside edges of our light source, holding it to the front of the diffusion panel on the outside of the light. This is going to again control the direction of the light, and you may want to keep in mind that it may add some weight to the softbox itself. Since this is already a fairly heavy softbox, you're going to want to have a very strong stand to keep this in line And if you put it on any sort of overhead boom, you want to make sure that you counterbalance that with sand or some other weight that's designed for that.
So there's our first video episode, episode 40, and stay tuned with us next time. We're going to have back to the interview segment.
You can give us your opinion on the show in our Flickr LightSource group, which you can find at www.flickr.com/groups/LightSource.
Till next time.
Cheerio.
I put you on the spot. You're like, what do we say?
What do we say?
I don't know.
PhotocastNetwork.com, your photography resource in the podosphere. PhotocastNetwork.com.